There's 9 members of the Planning Commission, and they are appointed by City Council, and they are designated 2 things: to hear certain types of land use cases or appeals of land use cases and render a decision, and then also to be the city's vehicle for public involvement in land use. People can come down to the Planning Commission and speak on land use items anytime, and then they hold a lot of public hearings, and so they take testimony during the public hearings. Planning commissioners are reviewed and appointed based on their interest first in being on the Planning Commission, and also any sort of education or experience that they might have being related to land use planning. There are limitations on the number of folks in the Planning Commission that can be developers or make their money in real estate, so it can't be any more than 2 of those. It's more that they are interested in the livability of the community. They are not able to talk to the public about the cases that come before them, except during the public hearing. So if you know somebody that's on Planning Commission, maybe your neighbor, you can't go knock on their door and say you really need to come to the hearing or submit an official letter, and I can't talk to you outside of that hearing process. So the Planning Commission sometimes will hear appeals of decisions that either I've made as a planning administrator or maybe the hearings officer has made. And then in that case, the Planning Commission's decision is final unless somebody appeals it to the state. And so you can't always, as the City Council, get them to review a decision. A decision that the Planning Commission makes can be reviewed by the City Council. So sometimes Planning Commission will review something like a zone change and issue a decision. And then maybe the person requesting the zone change is unhappy with that decision, or the neighborhood association or some neighbors will come together and they can appeal that to the City Council. Or maybe the City Council sees a decision and they say, I think that maybe I want to review that decision and have another look at that. They can also just request to have their own hearing on a decision like that from the Planning Commission. At City Council, you know, a lot of their day-to-day and the items that they address in a meeting aren't land use. You know, they do a lot of other things. They're elected to represent their ward, or the mayor, you know, represents the entire city, and they make lots of decisions on the budget and all these different city decisions. But when they do land use cases, they kind of, their role shifts in that they're no longer creating city policy. They're not legislators in that situation. So they can't go out and talk to their neighbors or neighborhood association about the case. They really switch to what's legally called a quasi-judicial role, and they're really acting more like a judge. And so when you think of it that way, and if you were on trial, you wouldn't want your judge to go talk to your opponent over a beer, right? Or coffee. And so people can participate, but it's through writing, submitting written testimony through the staff, or coming down to the hearing or logging on or whatever the situation is and actually testifying at the hearing. And that applies not just to the neighbors, but also to the applicant. So the same thing, you wouldn't want the city councilor to go out and have coffee with the applicant and tell his or her side of the case. So the idea is that everybody that participates knows all the evidence, all the arguments that are being made. It's made in an open and public forum. The applicant knows in the beginning, this is what I'm applying for, this is the process, these are the criteria, these are the standards you're going to apply, and everybody knows that going forward. And so the public has a hard time kind of understanding that, because they might think, this is really impactful to my neighborhood, and by you not scheduling a public hearing, you're saying it doesn't matter. And I'm saying, well, that's not what I'm saying, but I'm saying this is the process, you know, this is how you can provide comments, and this would be the process to get a public hearing, but it doesn't automatically start with a public hearing. So I think that's a misconception that people have, that if they ask me enough, I can just change the process.